This powerful and free automation that you can build with one of Google's new tools gives you an incredible analysis of your business from a local SEO perspective, telling you what you're missing out and how you can maximize your reach from a local SEO perspective. It looks at your website, at your Google Business profile, and a lot more things. And it also, secondly, does a competitor analysis. It researches and understands who are your main competitors, the things they're doing very well, and therefore the recommendations that you should be doing to outrank those competitors. This is an extremely simple but powerful automation that you can build for free. You can either use it to analyze your business or as an incredible lead magnet tool. If you want to offer SEO services, you can offer this as an initial analysis of the business that you're trying to offer SEO services to. And it's all with Google's new free to use Opal automation tool. So let me show you how to build it, and all the assets that you need will be in the video description below. Now, Opal is an experimental tool provided by Google, which means a couple of things. It's definitely not perfect, but for this instance, it is the right tool. It's very simple and easy to use, and it's only available in the United States. As you can probably tell, though, by the accent, I am not in the United States, but there's nothing that ExpressVPN can't fix or get any type of VPN server to put yourself in the United States, and that is it. You can now use Opal Experimental. I'm going to leave a link below so you can exactly copy the exact blueprint that I showed you before, but I think it's really important to create this whole thing yourself so you understand how this works. So the first thing we need to do is place in an input. What does the user need to place in so that the whole automation works? And then in this instance, I'm going to copy and paste here. This here, it says, enter your business URL, e.g. provide the business URL. And this can even be done if you don't have a website. Although if you don't have a website, your local SEO is probably not going to be that good. Anyway, and right off the bat, you can start previewing what this is going to look like. I can start and it gives me the wording that I placed in before, but I'm going to go to console. Perfect. So let's add a couple of steps here. I'm going to click this button here, which allows me to add another step to this. You can see here that right away, it's gotten the information from the previous step. So it's going to be referencing at any point throughout the prompt that you write here, the previous information. Now, in the description of the video below, I've got the first prompt for you here. I've actually got all the prompts for you, but you're going to copy the first one and we're going to fill this thing out. So what you want is in this places is where you're going to map the information from the previous modules. These things here, that's a module, that's another module. So here, for example, I can call the previous module. If I just press the at symbol, I can call all the tools that I've got access to within the Opal automation builder, such as web search, search maps, get page, get weather, and code execution. I'm going to say collect page URL. So now, tidying this up, let's get the first part of the prompt. It says, using the tools listed below, research the business, collect URL. And that is the URL that we placed in as the user input. Right? So now we have to place in the three tools that we want it to use: search maps, search web, and then get the information from that web page. And you can see that they're all listed. Again, if I go at, again, I need search web. I need search maps. And I need the get web page information. Now I can delete all this. So now I'm telling it, hey, get using this URL, get all the information as much as you can using the three tools that I've given you below. Perfect. So now I can go into the step number two. And step number two is understanding who the competitors are. So again, I want to go to one more module here. I'm going to go to generate. And this one is going to be named competitor finder. By the way, you can change the models here. So I'm actually going to get greedy and I'm going to go Gemini Pro. Not necessarily a complex task, but hey, if I can use one of the most powerful large language models, why not? Now for the competition finder, again, I'm going to get greedy and I'm going to use Pro. And back in the document that I've got for you below, I've got this prompt here. As you can see, it's nothing too complex, but you don't necessarily need to make it extremely complex. So using the tools listed below, find the top competitors for this business. So I need to call the initial module again, and you can see that it's this one here, collect URL. I'm going to give it this module, the same tools that I gave this one, whereas this one is researching the business, and this one is finding the competitors. So again, I'm going to go search the web at the maps, and then at the get web page there. And at the end, I actually don't need this one here. Now I need the final one, which is gonna be generating the whole business analysis. And you can see that these modules have names for research, business, competitor analysis, or competitor finder, I should say rather. And I'm going to mention those ones. I'm going to call on the information from those previous models from the last prompt that I've got for you here, which is the generate business analysis. This one's a little bit bigger. Essentially, what I'm telling you to do is first, give me an overall summary of the business, and then once and recommendations on what I need to do to kind of fix the overall structure of the website. Does the information on the Google Business Profile match the information on the website, which is something you really should do? And then I ask it for a competitor analysis. So in here, research this business, I need to call in the information that is research the business. So you can see how it's calling now. So this here is the information generated here. Right now I need to look under here, and the only one I need to change is find the competitors. And again, I need to call it by going at and competitor finder. So this part is now referencing this one here, and that is all good to go. Now I can test this out by previewing this. I'm going to go to the app, and now I can test the app that I've just built. I'm going to place in the business that I want to do research on, find the local SEO components that I need to fix, find the competitors and see what they're doing better than we are and what we can do. Now, after a couple of minutes, I get an understanding of the products and services offered by the business, who the target customers are, the customer reviews, and then an analysis of an alignment if the Google My Business is in alignment with the website itself. Analysis of the mission statement, detailed competitor analysis, so it's found who the competitors are. And it's given me website optimization. Yeah, perfect. So it's telling me I need more dedicated transactional pages, geographic landing pages, such as Puppies Cooling Ringwood, which makes sense because that's where they offer one of the services, but they don't have those geographical pages, Leash Your Activity in Fern Tree Gully, and review management. I mean, I could also just give this report to that business, and that would be an incredible lead magnet tool. Really easy, but very, very powerful tool. I think it slept on Google Opal. Now, learning how to use this tool is one thing, but then actually executing your SEO correctly so you show up in the AI search engines like Google AI Overviews, GPT Search, and Perplexity is another thing altogether. And if you want a complete guide on how to do this that is completely for free, I've done a video here that you can watch out, that you can go watch. It's a detailed tutorial on how to do SEO in 2025. It'll take you from beginner to pro, so you don't have to pay an agency and you can rank number one in the AI search engines and continue getting traffic, because traffic from the AI search engines, although it's getting a lot less, when it comes, it tends to convert 9 times better. So you get this right and you never have to worry about where your next lead is coming from. Again, thanks for watching.